Yo, what's up, world? It's your boy, Filochko here. You know that American dude with the incredible mood? That's me. And what am I making a video on today? Well, today I'm making another video that will help you to speak English much faster. And what's going to help you speak English much faster? Well, what's going to help you is using these informal contractions. Basically, informal contractions are words that are basically pronounced as one word. So you can have three words, put them together, and when you say them quickly and informally, so to say, they sound like one word, and it's much faster to say it that way. You understand? And these are informal contractions because it's okay to pronounce them. Everything I'm going to teach you, you can pronounce them anytime. It's okay. You can do it in a professional setting. You can do it in school, at university, and you can even say it with your friends when you're speaking English. You can say it anywhere, but you do not want to write this in any professional setting. If you write them like this, you will be absolutely wrong, okay? So you can only write them like this when you're talking to your friends, but when it's a professional setting, do not ever write them like this. You can speak it, but do not write it because it's completely wrong when you're writing it this way in a professional setting. So, let's get to these informal contractions. Now, even though I'm teaching you ways to speak English faster, I'll be sure to speak English slowly so you all can understand what I'm trying to teach you, okay? So let's get to the first four. The first four we have right here, I have mine here, but you have yours right here, have yours. It's whadja, whadya, whereja, howdja. Whadja, whadya, whereja, howdja. Do you recognize any of these four informal contractions? Do you recognize them? Just say them to yourself, maybe they sound familiar. Whadja, whadya, whereja, howdja. Do they sound familiar? Well, they should, especially if you're an Adam Lambert fan, one of them should sound very, very familiar to you. All right, well, let's get to it. Let's start from the top to the bottom, okay? First one, whadja. What words do you think come together to make whadja? Well, the words that come together to make whadja is what did you? What did you? So for example, the sentence, what did you do? What did you do? Said in a more informal, casual way, what'd you do? What'd you do? So if I come home and I see, like, my cat destroyed everything, I'll say, kitty, what'd you do? What'd you do? What happened? What'd you do? Like, what did you do, kitty? Why is my apartment destroyed, kitty? What'd you do? Meow, meow, I don't have a job, meow, you know? So, what'd you do, kitty? That's my way of saying, kitty, what did you do? Prosta. Next one, what are you? Now, if you're an Adam Lambert fan, come on, you should know this. He has a very popular song, what do you want from me? What do you want from me? Yes, what are you? What words come together to make what are you? What do you? Those three words, what are you is what do you? So instead of saying, what do you want from me? You can say, what do you want from me? What do you want from me is not cool. What do you want from me is pretty cool. It's more casual, you sound more like a native speaker, and it's faster to say and easier to pronounce. What do you versus what are you? Much better. Third one. Next one we're getting to is whereja. Whereja. What words do you think come together to make whereja? Well, I'll tell you. Where did you? Example sentence, where did you go yesterday? Where'd you go yesterday? Where did you go in America? Where'd you go in America? Where did you go in Russia? Where'd you go in Russia? Just like that, where'd you? Prosta, next one. Next one we get into, how'd you? How'd you? This one should be easy because the other three pretty similar. What does how'd you stand for? How did you? Perfect example, how did you know? How'd you know? How did you do that? How'd you do that? Just like that. Prosta. Let's review the four. Whadja, whadya, whereja, how'd you. All four of those, okay to say anywhere, but not really okay to write in a formal setting, okay? But okay to say anywhere. It's good. Next one we're gonna get to. Next one we're gonna get to is Adam. Adam. Now what can Adam mean? What words could Adam be squashed together to just be an informal contraction? What can it be? Well, I'll tell you, it's at him and at them. It's both of them. For example, I can say, don't point at him. Don't point at him. That can be both. Don't point at him or don't point at them. It's basically the same, at him. So I can say, I see that guy, I'm pointing at him. Or I can say, I see those guys, I'm pointing at him. both of them work. Now, maybe some places of America, they will pronounce it a little differently depending on whether it's a him or them. So maybe some people will be more precise with it. For example, maybe if they're speaking about him, they would say, I'm pointing at him. I'm pointing at him. Or if it was them, they might say, I'm pointing at him. I'm pointing at him. Maybe they can do that, but you'll be fine saying both of them as Adam. I'm pointing at him. I see him. He's right there. I'm pointing at him. I see them. They're right there. Both of those work. That is a really cool informal contraction that you should learn to use. You sound more like a native speaker and you'll be speaking a little bit faster. Next one. Next one, we're getting to these two words right here. These two made me laugh because it reminds me of a song by Celine Dion. But you see the word believe and the word din. Believe and din. What word do you think believe is? Believe. Well, I'm saying it basically the word that it actually is an informal contraction of is basically pronounced the same way. Believe is believe. Believe is believe. But we pronounce it believe. Just believe. And what is din? What do you think din is? I'll give you an example sentence. I didn't do it. Din is a contraction for did not. Did not. So here's a perfect example sentence with these two words. I didn't believe anything. I didn't believe anything. I could say I did not believe anything, or I could say I didn't believe anything. I didn't believe anything he said. I didn't believe anything he said. That works. And you know what? We can even add Adam to this, or we can add how sometimes we take out the first letter in him or them for example sentence. I can say, I didn't believe him. I didn't believe him. That could mean I didn't believe them or I didn't believe him. I didn't believe him. I didn't believe him. I didn't believe him. You understand? So I will give a separate lesson on the taking away of the first sounds of the him and them, stuff like that. And same thing with her. It also gets that sometimes, but I'll teach that in a different lesson. But this one was just basically focusing on the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 informal contractions I taught you today. So let's review them one more time. We have whatcha, like what'd you do, what do you want, where'd you go, how'd you know, don't point at him, and of course, I didn't believe you because I did not believe you. And that's the end of the lesson for today. I hope you liked it, I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you learned the stuff. Be sure to add me, vk.com/Velutsko, that's me, and subscribe to my YouTube page to see all of my videos. And that's basically it, people. You know what the guy says at the end of all of my videos.
And don't be racist.
So don't be that is his catchphrase.